threshold. So that's the distinction for importation of services. At the same time, there is a separate schedule which says that certain supplies, even without consideration, would be deemed to be supplies and would be taxable. So for instance, I will give you a few examples. If I am a lawyer, I have an office, I have 10 telephone lines. Out of those 10 telephone lines, there is some portion which is used for personal consumption. Those personal consumptions have been included. Secondly, today as we speak, VAT with respect to branch transfers to my branches in other states, there is a mechanism by which Form F and these statutory forms I can transfer the goods without payment of taxes. Those items have now been included within Schedule 1. So which means that whenever I transfer or supply any goods to my other branch in any other state, tax would be applicable. And because it is interstate, IGST would be applicable. So which means that because the government wants to levy tax on the basis of destination-based principle, looks feasible, but at the same time, we will have to see whether there will be cash blockage issues and so on and so forth. But at the same time, the relevant point is that today if we see litigation in VAT, 80% litigation is with respect to these statutory forms. The movement of goods based on these forms, Form C, Form F,
like similar goods
and computed methods and so on and so forth. But which would be applicable now to both goods and services? And hence, valuation would become very relevant. Because today if we talk about services, if I have to render services, I can determine the rate at which I need to charge my customer. But tomorrow, because of these valuation provisions being applicable even to the services, I may agree to charge 100 rupees for a service, but the authorities may feel that 100 rupees is under valuation and the correct valuation is 1000 rupees. So wherever there is a reasonable doubt, he can go into the details, unlike today. Of a particular film goes to, let's say, McDonald's, and in that shooting, when it is captured, they say that we will focus on this logo of your McDonald's for 7 seconds. So basically, Balaji is promoting the business of McDonald's, and McDonald's is giving space to Balaji Telefilms for shooting that film. But how do you value that? How do you value that? So even as we speak, under the current service tax provisions, it is difficult to value such transactions. But still, I had the choice of giving a value to each of these transactions where there was a barter and pay tax as per my need. I could have given 1000 rupees for five seconds, or I could have given 10,000 rupees. Would not have made any difference. But under the GST regime, that will be a challenge. And how much, that's why, is very relevant. I would not, and what we learned in the past, we will have to unlearn now. We were in the habit of computing excise duty at the time of manufacture, and it was, as was mentioned in the last presentation, VAT at the time of sale happening. We will have to unlearn all that. And what is now
bringing our threshold limit, not 1.5 crores, but 10 lakhs. So by bringing it to 10 lakhs, I think so everybody would be falling within the tax net of the GST. And another point, what they have done is, software is defined as intangibles and therefore regarded as service and therefore brought into the service tax net. There is a constant dispute that the rate of tax should be paid. I may also incidentally point out that in Britain, by the way, the corresponding VAT is 20%. They want to introduce now with 17 or 18%. I think it is fair. We should bring it even to 15% for the start. Why? Because in India, if you bring any tax, the tendency is what? Every year to go on increasing it. Unnecessarily,